our 147th episode of Marriage on the Rocks. I'm Crystal.
And I'm Seth.
Every month we have a drink with our discussion. And this month we are actually featuring a tequila from Califino Tequila. They are our sponsor for the month.
Yeah. Anybody watching, there's barely, maybe, like, what are you doing over there?
Sorry.
Jeez, you're getting all up in that line. There's barely any left. We have really enjoyed
the tequila. My gosh,
we've shared our typical how to make it drink. Mm-hmm. We've shared a couple of other videos with just using it. We made their firecracker drink. Our drink for the month was the jalapeno paloma, mm-hmm. which is what we're drinking
today
for the show.
Mm-hmm.
We had to do a shot of it. It's super smooth.
It is. Yes.
So highly recommend it. Get your liquor store. And if you don't have a liquor store, you can go to the Califino website.
Yes,
and buy it online.
And you can order it online.
They have
and
a
it's flat,
a flat
rate
shipping fee of like $9.99.
Mm-hmm.
And they'll get it to you quick. When they sent us the bottle, I mean, it got here
fast
once they said they wanted to sponsor. It was here quick.
Yeah, we're like, oh, cool. Because we talked to them in December, and then they were like, oh, well, would it be, you know, too quick of a turnaround to do January for the sponsorship? And we're like, no, we can do it. And so they sent it before January.
I didn't think we would drink the whole bottle in the month of January.
Me either. Oh my gosh.
Yeah, it's been good. We've really enjoyed it. We made several drinks with it. And
it's been really good.
The other video we shared was their firecracker drink, which had fresh strawberries, fresh blackberries, a couple of shots of the tequila, a little bit of lime, simple syrup. It was very easy to make.
Very easy. I mean, other than you have to
blend
it.
Liquefy, not just blend it, like liquefy.
Because that was so hard.
The fruit.
Everything. And we don't like to, well, sometimes like we'll do a video, we've done a couple of them anyway with the blender, but we don't want to annoy you guys because it's so loud. Califino, be sure to go to your local liquor store, and if they don't have it, ask them to bring it to your liquor store. So this week, or this month, we are going to be talking about Instagram whores.
Attention-seeking IG hoes.
I guess we can mention that.
If you're watching, you'll be like, where the hell are you? When we remodeled the house, we knew that we always had in our house, we had kind of our, what we called it, a travel room,
mm-hmm.
which is really all the stuff we'd collected over the years of the place we'd gone together. And we were like, well, we could probably turn that into where we want to record so we can quit doing them at the kitchen island and get a little more comfy. And so, does my voice seem deep?
I don't know.
It feels weird.
Really?
I can't tell if it's because I'm...
Because of the shot, maybe?
I don't know. It's weird. James Earl Jones. But, so we've collected these license plates.
For every place.
Every place we've gone together. We're missing one. We need... Indiana was the last place. We had Indiana and Illinois back to back. We got the Illinois, but we need the Indiana. But we kind of put this as the backdrop. And then, I know you can't see the rest of the room, but we got we also record our drink video in here. It's in a corner of the room you can't see. We got cigar stuff. We got the big barrel from Rocktown Whiskey is over here in the corner behind me that you can't see either.
Yeah.
So it's kind of it's just kind of a us room. I mean, the whole house is us.
It is. It is.
We do a shit job at catering for guests.
I guess.
It's
but
really
I think
just,
that everybody likes coming up. I mean, I guess like
it's funny
because
like
visit,
we don't have like there's no pictures in the house of family. We have like our wedding collage.
There's family in that.
You don't go down a hallway and you don't see stuff. I mean, we have a big ass picture of us
now.
Because
we didn't even have that before.
Yeah.
Really.
So it's kind of just odd how we've put it together. I don't think that
most people,
some people
would do
be like,
that
I don't
way.
Even have a picture of any of their family up anywhere.
I don't know. Yeah. So, but like, because when we took that little while off from the podcast, we were remodeling the house. And mm-hmm. so that's what forced us to really take the break. Mm-hmm. And then, you know,
we didn't
now,
want to come back.
Yeah, and so we're like, oh, crap, well, how much longer? But then we wanted to get this all ready, too. Mm-hmm. And
we wanted to, at least by the first of the year, to have be recording in here, mm-hmm. moving forward. So we got our comfy little swivel chairs in here, and uh-huh. we got the two-mic thing going now instead of sharing one. And I guess full transparency, we tried to record this earlier.
Oh, my gosh.
Like, a few days ago, and just had way too many technical difficulties.
It was awful. It was so bad. Yeah. Yes,
I was like an artist in a recording studio that was like, I don't get paid enough for this shit.
Yeah.
Flipping tables. And I'm like, I'm fucking out.
Yeah.
Call me when you get your tech fixed.
And then we had to make a healthy pizza and make everything better.
Yeah.
But, so, anyway, like I said, we're going to be talking about Instagram whores. And I think that... So, earlier in the week, we put out, or last week, I guess, by the time you hear this, we put out a picture of me, that
changed
said,
my mind.
Yeah, it was a change my mind picture, meme, or whatever. Mm-hmm. What did it say?
It said, fitness booty pics are
just Instagram attention whores.
Yeah.
Change my mind. And so, I wanted to put it out there because... One, I knew that there would be some people that agreed with that. Well, I guess most people did.
Yeah,
well,
more people agreed than I thought.
Yeah, and then I also wanted to kind of stir up some shit mm-hmm. and see if anybody would really kind of come back with, no, you're wrong, or whatever. I don't agree.
I was surprised. No, the amount of fucking girls that do this and not one of them wanted to even attempt to justify it.
Yeah. I know.
I thought it was weird.
Well, and maybe they do know that they are attention
whores. Well, if you know
whores,
that's what you're doing, then you know? You're just owning up to it, and more power to you.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Or, like, I guess it would have been funny if they would have been like, yeah, I know,
yeah,
I'm an attention whore. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
But yeah, I mean...
We didn't say there's anything wrong with it.
No.
We were just saying,
the
girls that do this, you're doing this for attention.
Yeah. Oh, for sure. Yeah. Huh? Yeah, I know. So, but anyway, of course, everybody always sees stuff, like, on Instagram that you're like, oh my gosh, you kind of roll your eyes, and you're like, really? You're mm-hmm. just fucking doing this for attention. And so, we wanted to talk about it.
Yeah. Well, I think that we had really kind of three things that three separate women mm-hmm. said or did or kind of exposed and stirred the, at least the thinking pot of, is this something here? Because I think that we all kind of, you know, get on social media and you know, inevitably you're going to be doing the hard eye roll on stuff you see. And I think that because we are part of the fitness community, we probably get it more than people that aren't.
Mm-hmm.
But I think that it was just kind of like, it hit a point where it's like, you know, this really has nothing to do with fitness.
Yeah.
It's really just, you are just wanting, you think your butt looks good. Most of the time you think it looks better than it really does.
Yeah.
But you think it looks good. You're proud of what you hide behind. These girls use words like, I've worked for this, or, you know, this is motivation, this is inspiration, this is hard work, this is my gains, this is whatever it is. They hide behind it. When in reality, you think your butt looks good and you just want to take a picture of it and show it.
Mm-hmm.
And you could apply this to what anybody and almost everybody does, that they think that they're proud of something that they've done.
Mm-hmm.
Or an attribute they have. I mean, girls with pretty eyes or pretty teeth or pretty smile or pretty hair or, you know, can do makeup good. It's all the same thing.
Mm-hmm.
It's just, it starts to kind of just teeter on the line of, this is getting kind of ridiculous.
Yeah.
And, you know, I think that one of the things that, that I had initially seen, well, do I talk about the, the girl that was getting the DMs or the girl that was like, you only see whatever. I'll talk about that first.
Okay.
Right?
Sure. Because
that kind of frames it. I think that was really kind of what framed the conversation initially was this one woman posted on her Instagram account who does nothing but shares daily photos of her squatting. Squatting or doing some kind of butt exercise every single day. And then in between the butt exercises are pictures in thongs and pictures in bikinis and pictures of doing whatever else with her ass showing.
Mm-hmm. I think it's funny when they're like, tricep day, and then they show their ass.
Their butt. Yeah.
Okay.
Had a killer upper body day today, and it's a picture of their ass.
Yeah.
All right. Shut up.
Yeah.
But that's all she posts on social media was ass workouts, selfies, butt selfies, whatever it is. And then actually has the nerve. I don't know exactly what happened to prompt this. I mean, we can all imagine what happened or the things people say. But then she puts out this post like, basically, I don't remember exactly what she said, but basically it was, don't judge me by the small amount of my day I put out here on Instagram. That's not who I am. And I'm like, shut the fuck up. You are driving the perception that people have of you.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
And you're not allowed to complain about it when someone's like, oh, hey, yeah, show me more ass. Let me see that ass. Nice ass, girl. When that's all you show, you can't get upset when that's what's happening. Or that's when, or even if it is, you know, the other women or women in your local PTA or you go to church with or whatever it is you do who now see your what should be embarrassing posts of your backside, say something to you about it. Be like, well, don't judge me.
Yeah.
You know? I mean, if you snort cocaine for 2 minutes out of the day and you're not allowed to be like, well, that's only, you know, 2% of my day. That doesn't mean I'm a drug addict. Oh, right. you only see the 2% of me snorting coke.
Yeah.
But I'm not a cokehead. Yeah, you are.
Well, I know. And it's funny because it's like, oh, gosh. what everyone, I mean, it's the perception. It's what everyone else sees. And, yeah, you are only, everybody only shows, you know, tidbits. I mean, I guess maybe there's some people that you're like, oh, my gosh, like, you fucking get over it. Like, you know, all you're doing is posting. But for the most part, everybody that posts, we only post little things here and there.
Mm-hmm.
And what you post really kind of, I think, it, like, represents how you are.
You are in 100% control of how people perceive you.
Yes, yes.
I mean, and then that's what you have to take ownership for.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, this type of woman, you're sharing more than a percentage of your day. When you post immediately when you fucking wake up and I gotta see what you look like when you roll out of bed, and then I gotta see what you and your kids are having for breakfast, then I gotta see pictures of you in the dropout line at school, and then I gotta see pictures of you at the gym, and then pictures of you at your post-workout meal. I mean, you chronicle your entire fucking day. We aren't seeing a piece of it. We are seeing your entire day. And the consensus is you show your ass too much.
Yeah, I know.
So, and once again, just own up to it.
Right.
Yeah, I do. I know that if I show my ass 6 times a day, I'm going to get a lot of likes, and that's what keeps me going.
Uh-huh.
Because I'm unhappy in my marriage, and I hate being a mom, or whatever the hell it is that you dislike about your life.
Uh-huh.
You live in the moment of the likes.
Yes, I know. Because you see girls that, like, start out their kind of like fitness journey or whatever, fitness Instagram page, and they of course like name their Instagram,
they throw fit,
crystal fit, or whatever,
or something journey,
CK or, fit,
something, there's always some kind of tag that, you know, you have to be labeled as,
and so they started that way, and then, you know, initially they may start out with, like, it really, really just being about their journey and about their fitness journey.
Which, First of all, nobody gives a shit about. So don't think that everybody's waiting to see your fitness journey from start A to from point A to point B.
Well, this is going to be really mean, especially coming from me as a personal trainer. But you just know that most of them aren't going to last anyway.
Yeah. And when I say nobody gives a shit, I don't mean nobody. I mean the general public doesn't care.
Yeah.
And all I'm going to say is if you want to have, you know.
Eventually, I mean, if you do go down the whole thing and you actually do meet your goals.
Well, that's when it matters.
That's when it's like, oh, wow. Okay. Yeah.
That's when it matters. That's good when you share your story.
Yeah.
But I think what I was going to say was if you're going to, you know, be out of shape and decide to start going to the gym and decide to quasi eat healthy and you're going to throw, you know, whatever Megan fit into your profile. When you fall off the wagon in 60 days, at least change the fit to fat. That's all I want to see at that point. Because you're no longer in the fit journey.
Yeah, I know.
Like, well, I was Megan fit at the New Year's resolution, but it's March. I'm done, so I've changed my handle to Megan fat. It'll be fit again and after Christmas when I feel bad about how I didn't do anything all year.
You're funny. Yeah, that's that's true.
Yeah.
I know. But so, yeah. I think it starts innocently enough. Yeah.
And it's pretty sincere.
Mm-hmm. It is.
I still think people want attention out of it, though.
Yeah.
People have that mindset. They want the cheerleaders.
Yes.
They want people to cheer them on. You can do this, girl. You got this, girl. You were beautiful before, so don't let anybody take that away from you.
Uh-huh.
But wishing you best of luck.
You're already beautiful.
You've got this.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, it's the same cheesy, corny bullshit that everybody says.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
And, you know, meanwhile, I'm like, yeah, talk to me in 6 months when you actually finish.
Uh-huh. I know. Yeah. Yeah. If you finish.
Yeah.
Yeah. But, so it starts out that way, and then you see them post, like, you know, pictures of them flexing. Oh, I made it to the gym or whatever. And then
I wish there was audible for eye roll noises.
Yeah. Right.
So that's what I'm doing right now.
Yeah. Yeah, Tony Stark.
Yeah, eye rolling my face off.
Yeah. But so you see them do that, you see them, you know, post stuff maybe of what they're eating. Well, I don't even know if I want to get into what they're eating.
The crap they think's healthy, but it's not.
Yeah.
Here's my protein cookie with 400 calories and 85 carbs and 25 grams of fat.
Oh, my
gosh. But it's a protein cookie, so I'm eating healthy.
Yeah. But then, and then you see them, you know, doing their workout videos or whatever, showing clips of them doing other stuff.
They go to the, it's funny because most of the people that do this never learn the basics of what they have to do.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, there's this one girl that we both follow on Instagram. We actually, she shared something, or we'll talk about something that she's done as well. But she has shit form. Does not know how to do any single isolated exercise at all.
Mm-hmm.
She kind of eats healthy most of the time. She goes to the gym every freaking day.
Mm-hmm.
Shares the same stupid pictures and videos every freaking day. But has the worst form ever.
Oh.
And somehow it hit her brain at some point in time that was like, you know what? I think people really want to see videos of me working out.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Yeah, I know.
And that was a conscious decision that people make a lot.
Yeah.
That are like, oh yeah, people really do care about this.
Yeah.
And I'm not, I know people may be like, well, fuck you, because you guys shared videos of you working out. Yeah, we're actual trainers who are trying to actually show the right shit to do.
Yeah.
It's different.
And I've shared, I try not to overly share, like, videos and stuff, just because it's like, because I know that there's just so much of that out there.
Yeah.
And like you said, I don't think that anybody really even cares. You know?
Yeah.
I don't know. It's like, even as a trainer, I don't think that people really give a shit. Like,
I mean, there's got to be 10 billion fitness videos out there.
Oh, yeah. A shit ton. I know. Yeah. So, and I'm not some Instagram influencer that is actually going to. And maybe that's the thing, too, is that these girls actually think that they
Well, that's what they're trying to become. I think that a lot of it is, and once again, it's 100% driven by attention. And they think that, well, if I get enough attention, maybe I can get paid to do this. Maybe I can be sponsored by this. Maybe I can do that. You know, whatever it is. And everybody thinks that their story is very special and very unique and very motivating and very inspirational. And the reason they think that is because that's what all of their idiot friends who are doing the same thing tell each other.
Yeah.
You're such an inspiration, girl.
Yeah, I know.
You know? And it's like, well, we really kind of devalued the word inspire.
I know.
It didn't, you know, mean what it used to mean at all.
I know.
Same with motivate and all of that stuff. Yeah. It just doesn't mean what it used to at all. Mm-hmm. And it's like, anybody that has a camera phone now can inspire.
Mm-hmm. I know. Yeah, I don't know. And I think it's funny because people are probably like, you guys are just a bunch of haters.
Well, and I think that, you know, the flip side of it is really, you know, as much as I complain about social media, if someone was like, then get the fuck off.
Uh-huh.
What, this is exactly what it's for.
Uh-huh.
And if someone was like, well, what about you guys? You know, you guys share, you know, whether it's a sexy bedroom photo shoot or whatever, you're just doing that for attention.
Yeah. We are.
Exactly why we're, that's why we can sit here and say, I know what you're doing too, because we did it for attention, and we still do it for attention.
Yeah.
So.
I know. Yeah. It takes one to know one.
Yeah. But I'm not hiding behind, I would never share a picture of us half naked or naked in a bed or naked on our couch and then hide behind some kind of bullshit quote about how successful and proud we are of our marriage. No, it's to show some skin and get attention.
Yeah.
So if that's what you're doing, just do it.
I know, don't like take some motivation.
Yeah,
quote.
Don't take a picture of your ass and then be like, and then share some quote from Martin Luther King Jr.
Yeah.
Below it, you fucking twat. That's ridiculous.
Uh-huh.
You know, at least be upfront with what you're doing.
Yeah, I agree.
Just say, here's a picture of my ass, because when I share my butter face, I get 20 likes, but my ass gets 400. So here it is.
Yeah, well, and that's the thing. That's what it turns into. So, like I said before, it starts out pretty innocently.
Mm-hmm.
And then it morphs into this attention whore.
Yeah.
And
you get addicted to the attention.
Yes. And so, and it's like, you know, I guess like initially they may want a little bit of attention or whatever, but then they all of a sudden feel good about themselves, like, I don't know, after 3 workouts. And and then they post a picture of their quote-unquote glute gains or booty gains, and so they post a picture of their butt, and they're like, oh man, like, they look in the mirror, I think, first at the gym, and of course they're doing their little poses trying to stick out their
make their butt look as big as possible.
Yeah, and they're like, oh man, dang, look at that, like talking to themselves, like, oh wow, like I really look good. And then they're like, should I take a picture? What if someone walks into the dressing room? Or what, not dressing room, but...
the bathroom, locker room,
whatever. Yeah, locker room. What if someone walks in? Okay, I'm going to take a picture. And then they take a picture. And then they're like, should I post this? Yeah.
And that's where the may take down later came from.
Yeah, yeah, exactly, yeah. Felt cute, yeah. But so anyway, so then they finally, like, I guess, get the courage.
Hey,
to...
do not throw courage in the realm of this at all.
Okay.
They finally decide that they want to share the bit. There's nothing courageous. There's nothing courageous about taking a naked or half naked photo of yourself and putting it out there for the world to see.
Yeah, it's just attention. It's just you're just seeking attention. And so they decide, well, shoot, okay, I guess I'm gonna post this. Mm-hmm. It may take a couple weeks or something, but they post it, and man, yeah, I really did look good.
Mm-hmm.
And then they post it, and then they notice that they get a shit ton more likes from posting that one picture.
And a bunch of desperate fuckhead dudes that post little fire emojis and peach emojis and dang girl.
Or
and,
like the like tongue.
Yeah, you fine. Yeah, the tongue in the water.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. And you're like, oh my gosh, yeah. Like tongue.
And they're
water,
like,
yeah.
Ew, gross, but that's what you want to get.
Yeah.
That's exactly why you're doing it.
Yes, exactly. Well, and they're like, ew, gross, like, but if it was some, like, because then they look at the dude who is, like, acting that way, and then they're like, oh, that dude's gross, or, ooh, that dude's hot. Like, it just depends on, mm-hmm. on who it is that gives
no,
them the attention.
I'll go ahead and settle this right now, ladies. No worthwhile catch of a man is commenting on your booty pics.
Mm-mm.
Ever.
Mm-mm.
Ever, ever, ever.
No.
Guys that have class, guys that have tact, guys that are actual fucking catch, are not trolling the internet looking for half-naked women to make some lame, stupid, three-word comment hoping that she's gonna fall in love with them.
Yeah, exactly.
So, any guy that's doing that is a piece of shit.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Yeah, so, go ahead and refer to some of our past episodes on, like, where to meet. What one was that? Like, dating, was it, like, dating out of your comfort zone?
Yeah,
or
something like that.
But, yeah, like, you're dumb to think that, if you do think this, that you're gonna get any worthwhile mm-hmm. partner out of posting these types of pictures. And you may not, you know, even care. I guess the single girls, okay, whatever. Like, if you're doing this and you're married, too.
Oh, that's even worse.
Oh, my gosh. And, I mean, we have, we've had people reach out to
men.
The podcast. The men, yeah, men reach out to our podcast asking us for advice and help because.
Exactly this issue.
Yeah, their wife is.
An Instagram attention whore.
Has come to be an Instagram attention whore.
And it's the same story you just shared.
Yeah.
It was never, I met my wife at the gym. We were both into fitness, and I can't handle how she does this.
Mm-hmm.
It's always been the same story. I met my wife, whatever, high school, college, military, whatever it is, when you meet people,
mm-hmm.
and she had kids.
Yes.
And now she's gotten in shape.
Mm-hmm.
And now she won't stop showing her tits and ass all over Instagram.
Mm-hmm.
And it's the same freaking story with little differences, but we've had multiple dudes reach out with this same issue of
mm-hmm.
what do I do? I'm feeling, and you know, I'm kind of generalizing all of them into one person,
mm-hmm.
but you know, they feel insecure about it. They feel unsure about it. They feel, and we've at least two or three of them have gotten divorced.
Yeah.
We've been updated on
uh-huh.
that. They've gotten divorced over this. And once again, we fully understand and recognize that we are only getting one side of the story.
Yeah.
The reason the woman may be doing this is because the husband isn't giving her the attention that she deserves
mm-hmm.
at home.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I don't know.
Deserves or wants.
It's really hard to play the what if with us.
Mm-hmm.
Like, if I didn't, you know, I mean, even today. I mean, how many times have I smacked your butt and complimented you on your butt today alone?
I know. Yeah.
And it's 2:50 in
uh-huh.
the afternoon.
Yeah.
If I ignored you when you were changing clothes or getting out of the shower or sitting in a chair and your butt sticking out or whatever, if I just ignored that, you know, it's hard to be hypothetical, but I could see.
I would be upset.
Well, not only that, but I think that being upset and feeling ignored would start to translate in, I need attention from someone. And I don't think it really initially registers as, I want attention.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's confirmation. I think it's affirmation. I think it's reassurance. I think it's other fancy words
mm-hmm.
for attention. But you initially want attention from your partner that you aren't getting.
Yeah.
I mean, we've known women that you could tell when they were in an attention lull
mm-hmm.
from their partner. Because
yes.
their photos started to be about their boobs. Their photos started to be about them be wearing less clothing, and
mm-hmm.
you just, and then you would find out the details that not that, oh, they would never say, oh, I posted a photo of my tits because my husband or boyfriend wasn't paying attention to me. You just found out, yeah, we've been fighting a lot,
yeah.
and we haven't been having sex, and
mm-hmm.
and it's like, okay, well, I don't think you intentionally were like, well, we're fighting and doing this, so I'm going to share these photos to make him mad.
Mm-mm. No.
But I think that it's a natural thing and feeling and emotion and desire to want attention from someone. Mm-hmm. So I'm not saying that that's wrong to feel that way. Mm-hmm. I think it is wrong when you become addicted to it.
Yeah.
And I think it's wrong when your partner is willing to give it to you. And I know that out of the men that reached out, you know, there was someone very, like, be clear that I think she's gorgeous. I tell her every day she's beautiful. Yeah. I don't know what she's not getting from me that is making her do this. Mm-hmm.
I think, anyway, it's coming from him, and it's not someone that
she doesn't want the attention from you.
Yeah.
And that's a hard thing to say to someone or accept. Uh-huh. Well, attention's great, but attention from you just isn't worth it.
Yeah. I know. Yeah, that sucks.
And then, you know, you see these women that were acting that way, and then they end up divorcing the person that reached out to us, and they end up getting in another relationship, and they stop acting that way.
Yeah, I know.
And it's like,
yes.
The dude's like, how do I not take that personally? It's like, well, no, you should take it very personally. Uh-huh. It was you.
It was. But I think that, yeah, you do need to take it personally, but you need to self-reflect.
Yeah.
And like, see, well, what the heck is it that I don't think he was doing anything wrong. It's just the partner that you're with. You need to be with someone that is.
Well, I wonder how much of it sometimes from married women are really the don't touch the stove because it's hot. Mm-hmm. Like, if she goes through the typical scenario you gave, which is 99% of them, mm-hmm. and you know, one of the things that we've discussed before is really kind of the sadness piece of watching someone who really is on that journey become this attention person, mm-hmm. Or attention whore. And it's like, damn, it was so sad because you were actually doing really good. And now it's just all about how much skin you can show.
Yeah.
But I think going to the scenario you laid out of the progression of what these women typically do and how they go through this process, mm-hmm. I'm wondering how much of it is they hit that point when they start to feel good about themselves. They do it. They share a photo. Maybe it's not even a thong. Maybe it's they just have leggings on and they want to show off what they think that their butt looks like in leggings. And the husband makes some kind of smart-ass comment like, well, thanks a lot for showing your ass to everybody on Instagram. Mm-hmm. And how much of that is like, oh, okay, well, are you trying to control me? Because mm-hmm. I can show all of my ass if I want to. It's my ass. Mm-hmm. And by the way, you aren't going to get any more of this ass. You know, how much of it becomes this spiteful type of...
exactly.
You're not going to tell me what to do. Mm-hmm. I'm going to do this.
Well, I know. And I think that, like... Oh, go ahead.
I know I've said things very blatant mm-hmm. about, like... You know, I'll share a picture. Some of you that follow me on social media, I'll share a picture of Crystal. And... fully clothed mm-hmm. in workout clothes and be like, I'm so glad my wife does not act like these women on Instagram who have to do this. And then the next day in somebody's story, you know, will be a woman standing there in the Planet Fitness bathroom, staring in the mirror, flipping the mirror off, like, I'm showing off my gains. Like, and it's like, yeah, I'm sure you're directing that to me or people like me.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
And so I think that that's one of the things that they feel very validated in what they do. And it's hard to argue that. If you're a girl that's showing your ass all the time, and you're getting thousands and tens of thousands, you have 15,000 followers, and every post is generating, a you know, 400 to 1,000 likes a post, mm-hmm. me saying, stop showing your ass, you're probably like, well, you're the one that's wrong, because all of these people here would disagree with you.
Yeah.
And I'm not saying that guys don't want to look at your ass. That's part of the problem.
I know. Yeah, I know. There was this one dude that, like, reached out, or that, like, messaged me and said, well, they have to be, what did he say? They have a place, too. That's what he said. Mm. And I know that it comes from a place of...
And he said it kind of tongue-in-cheek.
Yeah.
Like, it's a dude that doesn't want to blatantly say, well, I like looking at it, so stop slamming it.
Yeah, exactly.
And nobody's going to quit doing it because we have a problem with it or other people have a problem with it. And that's not what we're expecting.
No, not at all. Yeah.
But, it's like, and that's what we had initially talked about with, and that's where, I think when we decided we were going to talk about this, I was like, well, I know how What was it I said about myself? Like, I know that people will be like, he's just trying to sound so self-righteous. Like, I'm not like, ew, girl butt, gross, ugh. It's not like that at all. No. It's really, and one of the things that I had told you was, when I go through social media, when I see people that I don't know, in any way, shape, or form, we don't follow each other on Instagram, we're not social media friends, I don't know anything. It's just some standard fitness model posing in a thong for whatever. I don't think like, ugh, she needs to have a little more respect for herself. Or I don't see it and I'm not like, that's someone's daughter. You know, I don't do that. But when I'm actually a part of your social media life, and that's all you do, and I know you're not getting paid for it. I know you don't have sponsorships. Don't tell me you're an ambassador for something. Anybody can be an ambassador for anything. It's just their ploy to get you to sell their shit. You're not actually sponsored. But I know that they're not really getting anything out of it aside from fucking attention. That's when I'm like, that's when the eye roll starts. That's when I'm like, just fucking pull your pants up. And it's because from my perspective and people like-minded, you look sad and pathetic.
Desperate.
Very, very desperate. And there's people equally desperate at you because there's so many desperate people out there. Those are the ones that are telling you, oh, that ass is fire. Whether it's girls or guys, whoever. That are cheering you on because they are as desperate and pathetic as you are.
Oh, yeah. I know. Well, and I think that, like, because I had told you before that, like, I think that women, the people that are like this, that do this all the time, most of them would probably hate on another girl for doing the same thing.
You think? Because they tend to cheer each other on a lot.
If they were actually
like physical friends, yeah, not just social media acquaintances.
Like, did you see what so and so posted? You know, type thing to amongst each other, like their friends.
Oh yeah.
Like, but like real life friends, I guess. But then, like, on social media, it's different. Like, you know, you don't really know her. You don't really know this girl, but you're like, oh, you go, girl, or whatever, because she's posting the same shit that you are. But really, I don't know. It's like, I mean, I know that girls in particular are fucking bitches, and they'll just act like that. They're so, what is it, like, they just kind of
two-faced.
Yeah, two-faced, thank you. And they backstab each other, and you know, they talk behind each other's backs or whatever, and when really, like, she should just say, or a girl should just tell her friend, dude, stop acting like a little hoe. Like, why are you acting this way?
Yeah.
Like, you, instead of, I don't know, maybe there is some friends that will still, like on Friday, you know, like, oh, look at her, look at what she's wearing or whatever, and then she's like, hey girl.
Call me when you get home from work.
Yeah.
Okay.
You know, like, that kind of thing, I don't know. It's two-faced, and yeah. I don't know, I think that, but I do think that the social media part of it, though, is, it's just a different ball game.
Oh, yeah.
You know, like, you see girls support each other that you wouldn't really support a friend. Like, I mean, I guess you wouldn't support a friend.
If she was your neighbor.
Yeah.
If she was, you know, the mother of your kid's friend.
Yeah.
You wouldn't support her.
Good for her. She's a mom. That's
the other thing that cracks me up. These girls do this whole, like, I'm gonna give 10 shout outs to 10 other Instagrams for what they do, and they don't all, they're all just social media acquaintances. They don't live in the same area, they don't see each other outside of social media, they're not really friends. But that's the same type of girl that would do that, but then her friend who has her own business, she won't support her in any way, shape, or form.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah.
Even though her friend may be in the exact same business that these other girls are in.
I know.
There's weird different rules for social media and people's comfortability where it's everything is, or there's so much potential for just a backhanded gesture all the time.
Mm-hmm. I know. I mean, I've had it happen to me personally. Oh, yeah. Like,
everybody has.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, you see people listening to other, even podcasts.
Yeah.
And they're like, oh, yeah, I listened to this. And it's like, oh, have you listened to ours? Oh, no. Yeah. You know, like...
But someone will be like, if you ever want great marriage advice, listen to
yeah,
these two like, dumbasses over here that hate each other.
Yeah.
And then it's like, hey, bitch, you know, like, I know you've listened to our podcast.
And I personally know you. Yeah. And, like, you'd rather support them.
Yeah, it's people you've never even met, never known, never going to see at all.
Uh-huh. Yeah. But it's like they don't want you to get any kind of recognition.
Oh, yeah. They don't want you to have the satisfaction that they are...
Listening to you. Listening, and, yeah. Yeah, and sharing, yeah, like, you.
Yeah.
I don't know. But yeah, I don't know. Social media and everything, it just turns into a whole different mess of things. And what was the other person?
Well, I mean, so kind of another one was the girl, you know, there's girls, and I'm seeing it actually, I say girl, but it's happened multiple times. I see a lot of women that will share the DMs that they get.
Oh, I know.
From dudes.
Yes.
You know, they will get up in the morning, they'll you know, kind of the same thing I just ran through. They'll post ass pictures at the gym, boob pictures in their closet, you know, trying to show off in whatever perfect pose they think they have in the mirror to show off what they think is good or positive about their body. And then men will react to that,
you know? Mm-hmm.
And I'm not saying they react appropriately, but I think they react expectedly.
Right.
I mean, what do you think, and that's always my question with everything with this, is what is the end game? What is it you're trying to do? When you take a picture of your tits hanging out of your sports bra, or your ass in a thong in front of a mirror in your bathroom at your gym or at home, or, you know, I mean, we've seen women that literally, I'm not exaggerating, will put on their underwear, bend over, and put their phone behind their ass and take a photo in the mirror.
Mm-hmm.
And be like, and then have a fucking survey question in the story. Want to see more of these photos? Yes, or probably.
Yeah.
You know?
I know.
And it's like, okay, you are the ultimate epitome of attention whore.
Okay, yeah. Well, then that's when you need to get your own freaking, what is it?
The OnlyFans?
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Start on. And I think it's just girls that are, like, too scared
to do that.
Yeah. Like, they almost feel safe. Like, that's what happens with these DMs. It's this. They feel like, well, I can share whatever I have in an environment, because it's not like I'm out in public physically where someone can physically harass me or come up to my face or physically assault me in any way. I'm safe behind the glass of my phone.
Well, not only that, but I think also that a lot of them are, and you see a lot of people, you know, post their stories, and a lot of the girls that post that kind of stuff in their stories especially are like, it deletes after 24 hours.
Yeah.
And good. So, as long as it... I mean, of course, there's going to be people that can screenshot that shit.
I was going to say, do you not realize that every story can be screenshotted?
Yeah. But...
Or recorded. You can record it.
I know.
If it's a video, I can record the whole thing on my phone.
Yeah. And so, if... I think that... Because I've seen girls even say that kind of stuff. Well... You may have seen this in my stories, and I wasn't going to post it as a post, but...
Yeah, they want to see how it does in the story first.
Yeah, this is what, you know, I did, you know, and it, you know, I've seen, like, boudoir shoots and stuff like that, like, in the stories, but then...
They'll show, like, one clip.
Yeah.
And then they want to know, like, should I show, like, the 15 proofs I have of this?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Yeah.
And then they do. They always end up sharing the rest, and it's like, okay, like, that's fine, like, if you want that attention, then do it.
Mm-hmm.
Like, if you feel that good about yourself, then do it, but own up to it at least.
Yeah.
And don't act like, oh, I'm just too shy to do this or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
But that's what they do. I think that they post it in the stories as a safe place to do it.
Mm-hmm.
And you were gonna say something about like it not being safe, like, or it's not like they're doing it outside
and mentally they say, well, this is I'm in my home,
mm-hmm.
I'm by myself. There's really no harm that can come to me in any way, shape, or form, aside from, you know, whatever emotional badgering you may get from showing that.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that what happens, but my question is, okay, so, you know, walk me through the process. When you as a girl decide that you want to go home and take a photo of you topless with a thong on, or in your closet mirror, bathroom, whatever the hell it is, whatever the setup is, when you decide, I'm going to show a ton of skin,
mm-hmm.
what is it you're wanting? If you're telling me that you're full of shit and it's not about attention, well, what do you think is going to happen, and what do you want to happen? Mm-hmm. Are you wanting just a bunch of women to be like, oh my gosh, you're so empowered, you're the definition of feminism?
Yeah.
Because that ain't going to happen.
Oh, God.
Are you wanting guys to hit on you? Are you wanting certain guys to hit on you?
I think it's certain guys.
Are you... And okay, so then what? Mm-hmm. I'm just like...
After they do hit on you, then what?
Yeah, what's the fucking end game here?
Yeah.
Is it literally that you... And that's why I go back to it. They're addicted to whatever endorphin rush they get from the... looking at that like button going up and up and up.
Yeah.
That, oh my gosh, I truly am accepted.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if that's it, if that's what it is, and it's all fake.
Oh yeah.
It's not real.
Mm-mm.
I mean, and that's one of the things that we've seen, women that are absolutely different on social media than a person.
Mm-hmm.
They're shy. They're socially awkward. They don't know how to carry on a conversation. And then on social media, it's look at me, look at me, look at me, look at me. They don't act that way in person.
Mm-mm.
So which one are you?
Yeah.
You know, because one of you's fake. Mm-hmm. And I'm assuming it's the social media persona, because I've seen your ass in person. And you would never act like an attention-seeking whore,
mm-hmm.
in a social environment, at a party, at a get-together, at work. Are you telling me that it really is you have a dual lifestyle?
Mm-hmm.
Of what it is, but I think that, you know, these women will share these photos, and then they will screenshot the DMs they get of men that are responding inappropriately. Like I said a while ago, inappropriately, but expectedly.
Yeah, I know.
What the fuck do you think is going to happen when you do that?
I know, I like that. I like how you say that.
Yeah, expectedly. Do you think men are going to see that and be like, oh, wow, I think that because she's shoving her tits in the camera, she's probably a really good, smart catch. Is that what you think dudes think?
I know. Like
you're a fucking idiot.
Yeah, you're not going to get a catch from
and
doing this.
If you're one of these... And the other thing that women do with this is their little handle, they try to hide behind safe pieces. They'll put, you know, mom in there,
mm-hmm.
or Mrs. Fit Woman,
mm-hmm.
you know, like no, you should know, or they'll put in their little profile, they'll have a wedding ring or taken,
mm-hmm.
or, you know, whatever, trying to make this environment as safe as possible. And it's like, well, are you doing that so you can show your husband, look, I have that, I'm Mrs. So-and-so with a wedding ring in here, and guys are just guys, that's how they're gonna respond.
Yeah. Well,
that you really want it?
Like, I mean, and that's the thing. That's funny too. Like that you say the Mrs. or whatever. Because my Instagram handle is Mrs.CrystalCarnes.
Mm-hmm.
But the biggest difference is that I don't share a whole bunch of thirsty ass pictures like that.
Well, and the kicker to me is when someone does have Mrs. or Mom, and there's not one fucking picture of the Mister or the kids.
Yeah, 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 I know. Yeah,
I mean, true. I will say, the only thing more pointless than showing a picture of your ass on social media is a picture of your ugly kids. So. choose. I'm gonna show that ass all day. Because I don't want to see ugly fucking kids.
Seth. Oh my gosh.
But I do see a lot of these women that the person, the husband they're with, if they are married, if you do finally see a picture of the husband.
And then you, like, see him tagged in it finally,
yeah,
or something.
Yeah, they are completely mismatched. He doesn't go to the gym. He's not in shape. He looks like he's 25 years older than her.
Yeah.
And it's like, okay, I get it.
That's why you don't want to show him.
I completely get it.
Yeah.
Well, it's like it didn't do any good.
And he's not giving you the attention that you want.
Yeah.
And
he's preoccupied with
even
work.
Even if he is giving you attention,
you don't want it from
his old ass. he is not a catch, and so you're like, and I don't know if these women are like subconsciously like trying to find someone else, mm-hmm, or something,
yeah,
you know, but like they know that they're not fully attracted to their dude.
Like I said, I still go back. They think it's a safe environment.
Uh-huh.
They always have the deniability of I didn't do anything wrong.
Mm-hmm.
And they don't understand that what you did wrong was the first step you took to share something that should be very private on a public forum. Nothing else that followed after that would have ever happened if you hadn't made that decision at the first point to show your fucking naked body on social media.
Mm-hmm. In the first place.
Yeah. If you had not done that, anything else that happened after that, inappropriate, unexpectedly, damaging, trauma, harassment, stalking, whatever happened after that, if you trace that back to why it initially started, it was your decision to put your fucking naked body on a public platform.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I'm not saying that people shouldn't be held accountable for how they react to that.
Yeah. I know.
But you have to take some kind of responsibility for what you're doing.
Mm-hmm.
And that's where these girls are like, they share these DMs. Oh my gosh, look, get out of here, creep. And it's like, well, what the fuck do you think you're going to attract? Yes, there are creeps out there that will respond to anything. You can take a photo from head to toe dressed like a nun with five children around you, and some pervert will be like, oh, I'd like to see what's underneath that robe. But that's a very, very, very small percentage. Mm. Most men out there are looking for an opportunity to have a reason to hit on you.
Mm-hmm.
Most of them aren't going to create one. You're giving them that.
Mm-hmm.
And when a guy sees a girl who's flaunting everything around, their natural instinct is like, oh, well, they're trying to show this off. They want me to compliment them on how they look.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, girl, they got a good-looking body. If these hands ever need to do a massage on you, hit me up.
Ooh.
And they're like, ugh, back up, no.
Yeah.
Well, what the fuck did you think was going to happen?
Yeah, I know. Well, and that's the thing, like, because it goes back to, if it was a good-looking guy that was doing that and not, quote-unquote, a creeper, that you think isn't a creeper, I guess. Like, it goes back to, no worthwhile guy,
yeah,
is going to respond to this shit.
Yeah.
Period.
And that is a question I have for the social media singles.
Mm-hmm.
If you are truly trying to find, you know, is there an appropriate response? I told you before, I don't know how to ask this on social media because I'm not looking.
Mm-hmm.
But I am very curious. What is a good social media pickup line? Mm-hmm. What is it that you want to hear?
Mm-hmm.
Because every loser is saying, you're gorgeous, you're beautiful. I mean, they say the same lame shit, and half you dumbass women eat it up.
Mm-hmm.
But beyond that, what is it that you want someone to say?
I know.
What,
yeah,
is a worthwhile pickup line, conversation starter?
Mm-hmm.
You know, something. Because I will see these girls share these photos that some guy's like, hey. They don't immediately come up, start showing, you know, eggplant. They don't send unsolicited dick pics. They don't start off with, you know, tongues and eggplant and rain emojis. They don't, you know, start doing that. They initially like, hey. And she's like, what's up? I ran across your Instagram profile. Saw your photo. You're really cute. Oh, thanks. What do you do for a living? And they start the conversation, and then eventually he's like, well, how can we meet? And she's like, ugh, no, cross the line. And it's like, okay, well, How much line were you going to give him?
Yeah.
What is it you want? And next, the other thing I'll say about this is if you don't want unwanted attention from men, aside from controlling the fact that you control everything you put on social media, you can also control who the fuck sees it. That's you can have a private account. Yeah. Don't accept every friend request from every fucking dude that hits you up with a friend request.
Yeah, you dumbass. Like, you can look and see who it is. You can look at his page. If he has a private page, then I would say no. Like, don't accept. I mean, I don't know. Yeah, I don't think that you should accept anybody that you don't want.
Well, and you can unfollow immediately. Yeah. So if they are private and blurb is like, oh, okay, well, first of all, if their profile picture on Instagram is not of them, it's a quote, it's a something, just ignore it right away.
Yeah, I know.
If they're just like a meme king and back up, you know, if
there's
it's,
no pictures of
you know,
him.
My profile picture is me.
He's an ugly ass dude.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, my profile picture is me, your profile picture is you, and... You know, one of the things I do on Facebook is I will look and see, like, what does it look like from the public view?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
If someone is looking at me, and then I'll look, holy shit, that's a post from, you know, 2014 when I was making fun of whatever, and I'm like, I need to delete that off of there. But, you know, mine's not private, yours isn't private, but I don't have anything on there that I would be embarrassed about or that I would be ashamed about or that I'm overly boastful about. It really is just... capturing certain moments in time.
Yeah.
But I'm by no means, I'm not a serial poster. I'll go weeks and weeks without sharing anything.
Mm-hmm.
And then maybe I'll share something once a day for like a week.
Mm-hmm.
It's weird how mine kind of goes. But, you know, you are in absolute control of the entire thing.
Oh,
so
yeah.
So keep your page private.
Mm-hmm.
If you just want reassurance from other women and motivate other women and quote unquote inspire other women, then only be friends with women.
Yeah.
Because you're not inspiring a dude. There's not one dude that sees your ass and is like, wow, I need to go ahead and go do leg day today. Ain't happening.
I know. Yeah, I know.
So don't say that.
Mm-hmm.
And speaking of that, one of the things you said whenever you posted the meme was you put in there, and don't...
give me some bullshit.
Yeah, don't give me some bullshit about you trying to motivate or inspire others.
Mm-hmm.
And we had one person that...
I disagree
with the post. And then they immediately went to...
What I said.
You said, don't tell me that you're trying to... And they're like, well, no, some people that are trying to inspire. It's like, no, you're not.
Yeah, and they've come a long way. Some people have come a long way, and they're just proud of the body that they have and this and that. And I'm like, yeah.
But you're the wrong person to bring that argument to.
Oh, fuck, yeah. I am the wrong person. And obviously, He was a non-listener and non-follower, I guess, of us, period. But, I think that it was, you know, like, I'm glad that he brought it up.
Mm-hmm.
But it's like, dude, no, I have lost that much, a substantial amount of weight. And I am very proud of my body and my journey myself. And I still don't post shit like that.
Yeah.
Like, I don't need to. Mm-hmm. Why? What's the point? Why would I need to post booty pics, like, when I can just look in the mirror and be happy with who I am, or take my clothes off in front of my husband and him be happy with who I am?
Well, you send me plenty of booty pics.
Yeah, and just send them to your significant other.
Mm-hmm.
But, like we were saying, I guess these girls, like, they just don't, maybe they don't get the attention that they want or deserve or whatever. And so, even sending your husband, which that's your sign there that you shouldn't be with him if you don't want to send a dirty or a, you know, not even a dirty booty pic, but a cute booty pic to your...
Mm-hmm.
To your significant other, like, maybe if you don't want to say that to him, maybe you need to rethink.
Why don't you?
Yeah, rethink who you're with.
Yeah.
And find someone that you would want to send that stuff to.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I mean, it's, once again, they are in absolute control of everything that goes out, comes in.
Mm-hmm.
They're going back to what we initially said, your perception. Mm-hmm. You control all of that.
Yep.
You're not allowed to complain or get upset when you're being perceived as something that you have flat out made everyone perceive or talk to you about everything. If you share a picture of your ass and dudes are like, hey, nice ass, and you're like, blocked.
Yeah.
What did you want them to say?
I know.
You know, you're an idiot. You're an absolute freaking idiot. Yeah. Is it just that you want to get off on sharing photos and nobody saying anything to you? Mm-hmm. I mean, I don't get it. And then the final thing that kind of comes with that is really hand in hand with that is the type of people that you attract when you behave a certain way on social media. Mm-hmm. When we said at the beginning, you aren't attracting worthwhile people. Mm-hmm. You aren't attracting good guys with anything going for them at all.
Mm-mm.
And, you know, then we see women pose the question, why is it that I only attract liars and cheaters and players? Well, because liars, cheaters, and players are the ones that are commenting on your photos.
Yeah. Oh, my gosh. Like,
that's you.
Hello. Have some self-respect and self-awareness, maybe, more so. I mean, I guess self-respect, too. But have some self-awareness, like, exactly what you're doing. Because what you're doing is putting yourself out there for these weirdo men to act this certain way towards you, and you are, like you said before, in full control of how you're putting yourself out there.
Yeah. Well, and that's, you know, I know people be like, well, shut the fuck up. I can post whatever I want. Exactly.
You can.
You can. Mm-hmm. You can post whatever you want that's allowed to be posted out there.
But don't complain about it.
Yeah.
After this type of shit happens.
Yeah. And people are allowed to respond to what you post in any way that they see fit.
Uh-huh.
I mean, we didn't even head down the path of, you know, somebody that's not in shape posting this and then someone being like, ugh.
Yeah.
Cover that cottage cheese fat ass up. I don't want to see it. And then they get mad. Uh-huh. It's like, well, are you mad because you do have a cottage cheese fat ass? Or are you mad because someone actually had the nerve to call you out on that?
Mm-hmm.
Which, what are you more mad at? But I think that, you know, looking into really kind of the overall goal or what they perceive as the goal and the end game of what they want, that's always just my ultimate question. Mm-hmm. Is, well, what is it? What is it you expect to happen? What is the ultimate result you're wanting? What is it that you think should or could happen because that's positive out of what you're doing?
Mm-hmm.
What is it you're promoting? The biggest why,
mm-hmm,
of you doing that? Yeah. What is it? You know?
Yeah.
And you know, I'm very, very curious as to what that would be. Because I think that, you know, if I posted a picture every Sunday morning in the congregation in a pew at a church, and then Sunday night I shared another photo going, you know, in the congregation at church, and Wednesday night I shared a photo at the congregation of church, and then Thursday I shared a photo of a youth group on a bowling trip sponsored by the church. What would you think my life revolved around? Mm-hmm. What was I doing? Well, I mean, he's a church-going guy, mm-hmm, that goes to church. I'm completely in control of that perception.
Mm-hmm.
If you constantly show skin and ass and tits and all this stuff, people see you from that way. If, mm-hmm, you have a bill like a duck and web feet like a duck and look like a duck, people are going to call you a fucking duck. You're not allowed to come back and be like, I'm not a duck. I'm a swan.
Mm-hmm.
You're a fucking duck, and you're acting like a duck, and everybody's just calling you a duck.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, once again, you're in control of it.
I think it's funny, like, with that type of thing, like, because I think that women will can post these, you know, these types of pictures, and you know, they're a attention whore or whatever, and like. And you say, you know, a duck's a duck or whatever, you know, you show yourself like you're a duck or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
But, like, if a dude posted certain things, like, and not the church-going stuff, but, like, I'm a club promoter. Oh, here's this club that I'm at, blah, blah, blah. And then, like, you just, you, you think that the dude is, like, you think he's full of shit.
Yeah.
And I wonder, like, why, I mean, a girl wouldn't be able to be a poser and, like, even if she is a poser to, oh, I'm an Instagram influencer. I mean, I guess maybe if she pretended to be like that, maybe.
I think that they are pretending to be that, though.
Uh-huh.
I think these women are pretending to be
influencers. And so maybe
Well, that's why they accept every request from everybody, because they are focused on how many followers they have.
Yeah.
And they know if they get more followers that they can potentially get more sponsorships, they can potentially, so they don't vet who's following them.
Mm-hmm.
But I think that
and
if
then
somebody
that turns
has
into the problem.
Yeah, I think if somebody has 12,000 followers, you don't know who even 10,000 of those people are.
Mm-hmm.
You've literally just accepted every follower that's come your way.
Mm-hmm.
And you don't know their intent, you don't know if they're real, you don't know if they're fake, you don't know if they're fucking Russian. You have no idea who they are at all. You just see someone following you. Okay. Thanks for the follow.
Yeah, I know. I guess I'm wrong, because then I guess, like, then there is people like us that are like, you're just fucking Instagram attention whore.
Yeah.
And
but that's
not,
what I was saying earlier.
Yeah.
They feel validated.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Because they're like, well, you know, these 12,000 other people can't be wrong.
Mm-hmm.
They like what I, if they don't want to see it, they don't have to look at it.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the other argument that they could have. And you're absolutely right. If I don't want to see it, I don't have to look at it. Sometimes I can't help but see it because it's all over my fucking news feed.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, I could easily just unfollow you.
Mm-hmm.
But then I wouldn't have anything to get mad about. I wouldn't have a topic for the
for the podcast. I know.
So
yeah,
that's why I don't like your shit ever. So I don't respond to your stories. I don't like your ass posts.
Yeah.
But you, believe me, you post that shit enough, we're gonna make an episode out of it.
Yeah. I know,
and
right?
I'm gonna get the last fucking word.
Yeah, yeah.
On your attention-seeking ass.
Yeah, and we're not gonna say who you are.
Yeah. I won't give enough detail so you can be like, you're me. And if you think it's you, I'm just gonna call you narcissistic anyway. Because it may not be you.
Yeah, I know.
It may be somebody else.
Uh-huh.
You know, it may be the other girl that takes the photo with the phone in front of her face showing her ass off every day at the gym.
Yeah.
Because I know I can think of 10 different girls that do that, and uh-huh. 9 of them are going to be like, he's talking about me.
If the
and only
shoe fits.
One of them's right.
Right?
But if the shoe fits, send a fuckerella, wear it.
Yeah, exactly. I know. Oh, man. I know. Yeah, I mean, I think that it's...
It really wasn't a problem-solving episode.
Oh, fuck no. It was
just
fun.
We did I think the episode we... Was the episode we did in Arkansas about this? That if you're married, act married? But that was really kind of from the comments we got from the men.
It was.
And that was a couple of years ago. I mean, well before COVID.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, it was. Well
in,
before COVID. Uh-huh.
Heber Springs?
Yeah, Heber Springs, Arkansas. And that was a sober episode.
Yeah, it was sober.
That was a,
but,
a Sprite
yeah,
Zero.
It was a dry town, dry county.
Oh, my gosh, yeah. I think that was, that was it, though. And a lot of people really liked that episode.
Yeah. And I don't want to say it's a continuation of it. I think this was really just derived out of things we've seen over the last few months of you know, kind of just, you know, initially it was just like, it was, here's what the guy says, and, you know, we, like I said in this one, we understand we're just getting one side of the story.
Mm-hmm.
But we're seeing what you're posting now. We mm-hmm. see these type of behaviors.
Yeah.
And, you know, part of it is appreciation for, you know, our relationship, or my appreciation for you of how you don't behave this way.
Mm-hmm.
And I've never had to sit you down and be like, hey, if you ever post pictures like this, we've got a problem.
Yeah.
And that's the difference. I mean, you said it in the post. That's the difference between having class and not having class.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that that's where, you know, what was it? Class over ass.
Yeah, class
just
over
have a little fucking class.
Choose class over ass.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Yeah. I mean, I think it was fun. I think that every once in a while it's good to have a fun ranting type episode.
Yeah.
And I think that it's cool to throw things out there and, like, ask you guys about, you know, how you feel about this or whatever. and get your feedback more so than, you know, am I the only one that feels this way? I know I'm not the only one that feels this way.
Mm-hmm.
But, I don't know, even having that validation from other people, like, oh, thank God, like, there isn't as many dipshits out there as I thought there was.
Yeah. And you know, and for every girl that's like, well, I had, you know, 100 comments on there of other women telling me how great I am. That same woman is showing that picture to her friends that will post, you looking fire, girl. And she'll be like, oh my gosh, did you see this stupid slut on Instagram?
Yeah, oh my gosh, look at this hoe.
And it goes back to the two-faced stuff.
Yeah.
Because we've had that before.
Mm-hmm.
People be like, did you see what she posted? Look at this. And then I see, well, you fucking commented on it. You go, girl.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, I'm going to be nice. Well, no, you're not being nice. You're being two-faced.
Yeah.
So you have to understand and realize that even the people that are complimenting on that are still talking mad shit about you behind your back.
Oh, yeah. Show.
You're not accepted.
Mm-mm. No, I know. Just know that, yeah. I mean, I don't know. I guess, like, these girls could be like, oh, any publicity is good publicity. Yeah. As long as I'm
And then laugh attention. All the way to the bank.
Yeah, so.
But I don't think I said on this one, but if you're getting paid to do it, kill it.
Yeah, own it.
Yeah, if you're making money on that ass, mm-hmm. make as much money as you can.
The thing
I'm
is,
not talking
though,
to you.
The thing is that these bitches think that they are gonna make money.
Yeah.
And it's like, girlfriend, you need to work on that ass just a little bit longer, because that ain't happening.
No. What's so special about it?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Yeah. Let me guess. It's got a crack, two cheeks, and a hole.
Right.
What makes it so special?
Right. But yeah, I think that it was a fun episode to rant about. And I think that, yeah, if you guys, like we said, we are just about done with this Calafino tequila over here. So if you get a chance, pick up a bottle.
Yes.
And we will talk to you next month.